album's like a buffet. There's loads of different stuff on it, isn't there? Every track's gone in a different... It's a really nice place to be in, I think, making every track sound really different. Like, we've got songs that are sort of sing-along, we've got heavy, heavy punk songs. You could call it a ballad, I don't know if that's a bit strong for us. A slave's attempt at a ballad.
A salad.
We've got a salad on the album.
Yes. She made sugar taste like salt, 'cause she was so sweet. Now you're shuffling your feet with your hands in your pockets. It wasn't her fault. She made sugar taste like salt.
When we started, there was a real sense of frustration and working shit jobs, and then ultimately you get to a point where you're really fucking happy that you're like having a career in music, and you become a more chilled out, happy character. So you start departing those angry feelings and you move on to something else. But I also just think it's where our head's at, and we are making heavier songs, but then we also just like making like melodies. And yeah, I don't know, it's not a conscious decision, because like in our consciousness we're thinking about, we want to make sure it still sounds fucking heavy. From my side, it's definitely more varied. When we started Slaves, I was like only listening to punk, like, and garage punk, so like Billy Childish, Crass, Black Flag, all those bands, Rancid, they're all I listen to. And now at the moment I've got like Kano, Made in the Manor, Stankonia, Outkast. I'm listening to the Crass record and the Black Flag records all over again. But there's so much more like hip hop influence that I'm listening to. And a lot of it's the beats and the melody. Bands like the Beastie Boys I was listening to today, because if you first get into them when they were like, had their popular stuff, it's quite easy to forget that behind the rapping is rock songs.
Right.
And I guess that's kind of the thing that we're interested in, is like how far can we stray and still sound like Slaves? Because tracks on the last record like Do Something, I don't think you could call that a typical Slaves track. It's not like thrashy, but it still sounded like us. And Are You Satisfied? So yeah, we just want to make an album that sounds different to the last two, but has the same energy. The feeling is mutual. You don't like what we do because we say what we are thinking, and that shocks and frightens you. The lion in the jungle shows no shame, it shows no pride. It does what it needs to stay strong and to survive, yeah. I think the album is like, there is an element of like being a purist about the album, because you have all this UK grime scene blowing up, but nobody's making an album. Like, I love listening to albums. They're like, one song can't be like a journey. Like, it's over so quickly. Like, an album is like, you know, you're going to school every day on the bus and you put an album on. You know, you're doing the washing up, you put an album on. And that's what's so important to me. So if you can't do that physically, then you need to sign up and it's changing. What if you love the first version? I like going back and hearing like early Black Flag demos where like you had like Keith Morris demoing a song which Henry Rollins finished. That's cool, but like, I don't know, I'm not into it. Please place your bet, yeah. You keep it, we don't want it. You keep it. Artwork's important and we're not going to stop doing that. And I think everything has trends. It won't be long before people get sick of all of it. I haven't met a single person that has Tidal. I don't know anyone. You're the first people I've met. Yeah. Nobody, do you know anyone that uses Tidal?
I don't even know what Tidal is.
See? 'Cause you're so boring when you're nice. I love you more when you're angry with me. 'Cause you're so boring when you're nice. When you're nice. It's so intense that you can't not say something.
It's interesting.
I said fuck Trump on stage the other night and got a wicked reaction. Because
being here and actually talking to American people as well, like, it's just crazy.
They know, the American public know that it could
happen
and it's out of their hands, and it's like, it's fucking so right wing. Why are they being put on talk shows? Why is anyone, it's like, that's wrong. Like, it goes deeper than just, people like that shouldn't be given the time of day. I don't know. Which, because like before that, you respected America as one of the most I mean, it's still, there's still a lot of issues with like the prison system and stuff, but they like respected it. It's quite a non, like, you know, they had the first first mixed race president, you know, like they were changing it, like all seemed to be like from 8 years ago to now, it's like gone medieval. Their live show at the O2 was one of the most, like, I've never seen production like it. The amount of effort and thought that went into it. And you put on a U2 greatest hits, and even the coolest hipster will nod his head to at least one of the songs. So I've become, I fucking like them. I think they're like undeniable, like prolific hit makers. And Bono is like, he's not up in the clouds. Like, he was asking me, he said to me, he basically said, it's brilliant that you're nominated for the Mercury, but I don't think they've got the balls to give it to you. It's fucking cool.
Yeah. Yeah, I think what you like record is your legacy. So I think already, like, the most, we're leaving stuff behind.
But the most important thing is that we didn't make music to get into the mainstream. We didn't make music that should be played on the radio or that. Because there are musicians out there who, like, I mean, if you get to a point where you have no other option, you'd play anything just to play music because you love music. But we play exactly what we want, and we make the music, the art that we want. And that's the legacy I want, to be like, our music sounds like no one else's, and they created that. And that's the most important legacy. When people put a Slaves record on, it's like, Laurie and Isaac did that, and no one can do it apart from us. And that's like, that's the thing. That's the thing that Joy Division had, Nirvana had, Kendrick, Elliot Smith, all the people that just made their sound. I just want to make the Slave sound. Are you satisfied?